Now, on the Play Store, there are a lot of apps on there. Now, so, finding apps that work with keyboard and mouse is next to impossible. But finding games that work with the mouse has been made a lot easier because more and more games are being released as standard with mouse support. So long as it uses one finger, your mouse classes as just one finger clicking around, so long as you use that in a game, it will run completely fine. So, ooh, Defense Technica. I've played that. That's pretty darn fun. Bejeweled Blitz. That reminds me, I should have got Tetris and all that for this, but I suppose I'll get to that there. So here's the part you've all been waiting for. Let's face it, the game. Is gaming on the tablet as entertaining and as fun in a desktop interface environment on the Android operating system? Is it fun? Can you play games and enjoy them? I wouldn't say more, because it's impossible to have more fun on this than on, say, a computer playing something like Titanfall or something like that. But can it be fun? Can it pass time? Can you be entertained? Now, I found a bunch of apps that actually work perfectly fine with keyboard and mouse. I'll go through them later. But I'm going to go through these little games here. These games, they don't work with the keyboard because, for a number of reasons, one, they're just one-finger buttons, so you only use your mouse anyway. Now, one of these games that only run in portrait mode is Flow. However, because of the landscape program, I can run Flow in landscape. However, as I'm going to show you, there are some artifacts. As you can see, this is meant to be a grid. That's the really obnoxious ad down there. Now, this is supposed to be a grid, but as you can see, all the lines haven't really rendered or generated or anything, but it's pretty darn interesting how this actually turns out. And as you can see, the game runs completely fine. You just have to concentrate a little bit and use your brain to do Flow, and you could play Flow for eternity with just a mouse. It just might give you a little bit of hand cramp if you aren't used to using your mouse a lot. Now, I'm going to go because those ads are going to drive me insane. Now, I'm just going to quickly close all these because I really don't need them open. And it's really going to waste time to actually close them all. Another game you could play, possibly, is Mayhem. Oh my god, Major Mayhem is a fantastic game. I made a video on YouTube, and I've just loved it since. I've got the Steam version, which is pretty much the same game. This experience right now with your mouse is essentially the same as the experience you have on the Steam version. So, people who have already played Major Mayhem on Steam should be right at home playing Major Mayhem on the Android device. Start, Classics, Metropolis, Mission 1. Now, I'm not amazing at this. I never claim to be amazing at these games. But it's pretty darn fun. Die, chicken! Like, instead of using keyboard to activate these things over here, you just use your mouse. But that's essentially the only difference between this and the Steam version. And I'm failing epically. Nah! Yeah, screw your face! I died. I just went a quick run through that game. Another one that you could play. You could play most of these games. Unfortunately, you can't really play Minecraft. Minecraft Pocket Edition still doesn't have any kind of support on mobile devices. The developers are assholes, generally. I'm sorry for any Minecraft fans out there. I absolutely adore Minecraft. It's taken over 4 years of my life now, and I love it and adore it. But the Pocket Edition, it has no gamepad support, so when I'm sat, you know, on a train like I am most days, I can't play Minecraft with a controller, which would be absolutely amazing. I'd love to do that. And it doesn't even have partial keyboard support. Partial keyboard or mouse support. It's got nothing. You can't even use your mouse on it, for crying out loud. You can't do anything. Now, on some devices, you can use your mouse, but I think that's for like the Xperia, and the other one's for the actual dedicated PC devices that plug into the like your TV. That's what I've read anyway. Slimes vs. Mushrooms, that works perfectly fine. That's pretty much a clone of Plants vs. Zombies. It's fantastic though. Another game I really like playing with the mouse is Galaxy IR. I'm just going to quickly throw in a really easy game just to show you the game. Now this is a portrait only game, but as you can see, it runs very, very well in landscape only. Now, these guys look pretty pissed off at me. So let's just defend my world! Now, if you ever played Euphloria, this game is essentially that. This game is essentially Euphloria. Now I'm going to send a whole bunch of people over to that planet and hope they win. They probably won't. Nope, they didn't win. Oh, defend! 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 Victory! Now, destroy! Now, I really love this game because you could just think, I sunk so many hours into this game because I loved Euphloria. I really, really did. Euphloria was one of my favorite games of all time because of how simplistic it was. Defending your own little worlds, sending them to other places and stuff. Galaxy IR is pretty much an Android version of that. I've even found games similar to that on iOS. Maybe I'll make a video of that one day. But that's essentially all the mice games, the mouse only games that I really want to show you. I mean, there's Minesweeper and there's Fruit Slice, but eh. Fruit Slice is just Fruit Ninja. A very free version of Fruit Ninja, but it's actually really good, and obviously you're just using your mouse and meh. It's just that. Now these, some of these work with mouse, but they don't play very well, unfortunately. Block Story has controller support, so you can plug in a controller and play it, but for some reason my bindings are messed up. I don't know whether that's me or the developers. I've yet to receive a reply from the developer of Block Story to find out what's going on there, but eh, that's apparently got controller support. These kind of work. They're slidey games. Subway Surfer doesn't recognize your mouse at all. I can't remember if Temple Run does. I don't think it does. Dungeon Highway I've not tried. Pitfall I've not tried, so I guess I'll try it now. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. If it says tap to skip and you've clicked your mouse and nothing happens, it's not really recognizing your mouse at all. So that's pretty a bummer. Now some of these work with a mouse, which is pretty interesting. Dead Trigger 2 I might just show you in a minute, because I'm going to do something different with that. Zombie Lane kind of works, but that game's been abandoned by the developers, unfortunately. Zombie Frontier, it does work, but it requires more than one finger, more or less, to play, because you have to aim and you have to shoot at the same time. With a mouse, you can use the mouse, but you'll lose very quickly. Zombie Smasher, that works. That works perfectly fine. You just click on the enemies you want to kill. I'm not going to show you that because, meh. So let's go through the games that I actually do want to show you. Now, Turbo Fly really, really impressed me because it actually has keyboard support. Keyboard support, and that's why it's in the keyboard and support. So I'm going to quickly go on Quick Race. This is the free HD version. Yes, I select, and I select that track. It's pretty much Wipeout for Android, but it's pretty darn fun. The controls are very simplistic. I believe it's just A and D and spacebar, I believe. Yep, spacebar fires a missile. Let's go shoot the missile at people, knock them out, try and get ahead. This is a really fun racing game, with the levels getting particularly hard after this one. This is just a quick race. As this is the free version, it's pretty much just a demo, so don't expect much from it. But it is really, really fun. I've got a couple of missiles, so let's use them. Take out a couple of people. Get a boost where you can. I am going to win this race. There we go. Racing ahead. I'm in third. Right behind you, sir. Oop. Nope. 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 How do you get ahead of me? But anyway, I'm not going to waste your time with that. So that was Turbo Fly HD. An absolutely fantastic game. Another one that works with keyboard and mouse is this Gunbank Live.
Unfortunately, I'm not very good at it.
I'm not very good at it. I've only played it a couple of times, but it actually does have keyboard and mouse support. I can't remember the bindings right now. Let's just throw it on easy and click on random places. Help! Help! Now, I can't remember. Oh, it doesn't have mouse support. I forgot. I tried adding mouse support, but it wouldn't allow me. So, but luckily it's got keyboard support. So I've set it to WASD for, you know, up and down. Woo. Get out of here, sir. And spacebar for jump out and right shift to shoot just to give my right hand something to do. Does that duck hurt me? Get out of here, duck. Ow. Probably gonna lose. I'm actually really no good at this game. But I really love the art style. I love the art style and I love the fact that I can just quickly mash buttons and play this game. So, yay, I got a new gun. It shoots free bullets. Amazing. So if you're any good at platformers, you'll probably like this game. Oh, won that cake. Yeah. So I won't go too far into that one. Right click on your mouse is pretty much a back button, so you can just pause with that one. Another game you could play is Cannibalt HD. Now Cannibalt HD is one of those fun little games that you only need one button for. And it's got keyboard support. It only requires one button, and it has keyboard support. So simple, yet so amazing. These simple things go a very long way when you're releasing apps on the Play Store. So you can use your mouse like normal, you can just play the game. If there's just pop, spacebar, and you can play the game. The longer you hold it, the further you jump. Slight taps is a mini jump. Fail. Don't know how to play this game. I'm really bad at this game. But I'm more used to using my finger. So, I'll just use my left hand for now. Hope for the best. Run! Run, sir! Oop! Didn't quite make it. Fail. So I'm not very good at that game, but that's actually got keyboard support and mouse support, as you saw, because I could use my mouse on the menu. So that's fantastic. Now, this game doesn't... It does have keyboard support, but it's one of those one-finger press games, so you may as well just use your mouse. It's got mouse and keyboard support, and this game has no ads at all. This game is a free game, it's fantastic, and I really do recommend it. It's called Scramble Net. See, you just run around, click, connect all these wires up, and connect your monitors to the network, and you go through the entire level. I'm currently an expert. Now, as you can see, you can use keyboard and mouse. Now, spacebar does something, I don't know what, it just makes it glow. Don't know why, I don't know what that actually does. But, as you can see, you can play this with keyboard and mouse. Maybe you prefer it with keyboard and mouse, but I just prefer it with mouse. In fact, I prefer it with finger, but, you know, if I was left with no other option, I could just easily just use this just to, you know, control it. So that's Scrambled Net. Scrambled Net I just recommend to everybody because it's a fantastic little game. Now another one is Wind Up Night. Now Wind Up Night does actually have keyboard support, but it's really weird keyboard support. I had to Google what the actual key bindings were because they were that weird. Now apparently it uses W and S, and then spacebar and left shift. So your hand is always over here, your right hand does nothing. It's really, really strange. Now you can use mouse and keyboard for this. I don't know if you can use mouse. No, you can't use mouse in this, so it's all... So use the arrow keys to navigate, and spacebar to select, however... It's a pain. I can't remember how to get out of it. Alright, so after figuring out what to do, what to press, I finally remembered just to press escape the back button to actually go back. So, for some reason it opens up on number 2. So I'm just going to quickly go on, let's go on number 3 and show you what I mean, whereas it's all weird. So you got, it uses W, S, left shift and space. I can't quite remember what they all do. Oh, Spacebar to jump. Spacebar to jump. That's good. And I think it's left shift to smack. Yep. Okay. So the objective of this game is to stay alive. Pretty much. You're a clockwork knight. You have to keep picking up cogs, otherwise you... Not cogs, wind up keys. Otherwise you stop, eventually. And you can collect coins for bonus points, I think. It's a really quirky little game, it's really fun. Right now we're only using two buttons. But we will be using more later on. So, let's press escape and... How do I leave? There we go. Let's press escape and go on a little later one so I can show you... No! No! Later one! Later one. I don't like menus that don't have words. It's a pain in the backside. So let's just go on the really hard one. Let's go on X. X. Hopefully it's using all the buttons. Probably is. Probably. Okay, so yes, so now we roll. So we can roll under there. Whoop, whoop, whoop. And we can jump over this. So yeah, pressing S holds down. Hold W to hold your shield up. And while I was too busy holding my finger with my shield, I didn't quite stop that. So before I show this game too much, and oh my god, I'm going to die. No. Bleh, wind down. So yeah, we didn't quite make it in that game, but Wind Up Knight's got keyboard support, that's fantastic. Now this one is a really fun little game. It is pretty much Galaga. I am a huge fan of Galaga. Galaga, I could play for days. Unfortunately, there's a clone, a chicken clone, Chicken Invaders, Revenge of the Yolk. It's a really weird game with a really weird sense of humor. However, in the options screen, you've got keyboard support. And you can set player controls right here. You can rebind the keys on your keyboard. So, WASD to move your ship. Fire is space. Missile, left shift. So, your right hand again is doing nothing. You can rebind a couple of things so your right hand's actually doing something. But, personally, I'm quite happy with just using my left hand for this game. Because, oh my god, I like this game. Asteroids. Oh no. So I'm past the Galaga part and I'm on this asteroid part. I basically have to destroy asteroids and avoid them and stuff. Game over. I've only just started. I've got game over. That's not really showing the game, guys. That's not showing the game. No, I don't want to really quit. There we go. Save the world. Start new mission. There we go. Skip, skip, skip. You can just left click to skip through things. So now I have to kill a giant chicken, I believe. Yeah, this is the prologue. Destroy the chicken, man! Jerk, 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 jerk. Oh god, the chicken's coming for me! And it's dead. Pick up all the meat. Yeah, you pick up meat for reasons. I don't know why you pick up food. Maybe it's health? I'm not quite sure. I have no idea. But anyway, then it eventually gets to the Galaga part. Finally. Yeah, get out of here, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so here you are like this. The Great Unknown. We need a little ship that you can control and go. You can go essentially all over the map with this, which is really nice. Ah! Killed me straight away, you jerk. Well, I'm back with Avengers now. Avoid the eggs. The eggs are essentially the way they shoot. Of course, because they're chickens. You can overheat your weapon, so always keep an eye on the top. But I really like that this game's got keyboard support. I was really made up when I was testing this and found that it actually had proper keyboard support. Don't ask how I found it. Essentially magic. Yep. Killed all those chickens. Die, damn it. There we go. Killed them all. Yay. So that's a fun little game. I don't want to spend too much time talking about all these. Another game that I actually bought, because you might have seen Paul Souls Jr. do a little Let's Play of this game. It's a fantastic little game, and you can actually rebind the keys in this as well. I believe, I think you can rebind them. I just launched it and played it. So I'm going to play as Mr. Dead, because because he died. Killed him. Creating dungeon. This game looks phenomenally well on Android. I'm actually surprised by how well it looks. So as you can see, we've got WASD, and I can use the arrow keys down here to look around, spacebar to swing, and other buttons to do other things, which I can't quite remember. So I'm just going to run straight into the action and see what we can do. I can't quite remember how to open. E. Right, gotcha. Shh. Shh. I can hear you judging me from here. So here we go, we're in dungeon one. Oh, we got a zombie man. Not today. Oh, you're not a zombie man. I think I can take you on. Yeah. Ow. Ow. Die. Did I mention that I'm no good at this game? Where'd he come from? Oh, I died. But as you just saw, that's got keyboard and mouse support. So that's pretty entertaining, and that's not the one I wanted to close. But whatever. The next one I want to quickly show is Cave Survival. I'm going to show Survival Craft last, mostly because it's an alternative to Minecraft, but with a difference. This one is a portrait-only game that's been stretched. That's why it looks god-awful. But I kind of like this game. This game is actually pretty darn fun. It's a Minesweeper dungeon crawler of some sort. Now, you're going through the caves like so, and then you run into these little creatures. You've got a health bar here, and you've got a magic thing here. And it's kind of like Minesweeper. So I'm just going to use my red here. Now, that failed, so that's obviously not green there. No, green. They don't go diagonal. So you kind of know where all these go. So it's kind of how it comes out as Minesweeper. So, it takes a while to get used to this game. It's actually really annoying, but really satisfying at the same time. So, you keep playing until you've filled in all the blocks. You just pretty much, you don't guess as much, but you just figure them out. So I beat him and I got 2 gold and a magic wand. And you keep doing that over and over and over, and you keep getting more gold, you upgrade your items, you get more stuff. Find treasure chest, go inside it. So, open up. I've got a helmet of war, so I've got more HP. So I'll take that. The only thing I don't quite like about this is the resolution, because it's a stretched game. It was portrait, now it's in super landscape. Now we're fighting another creature that we have to do. We have to pretty much minesweeper our way around, which can be annoying. So that'll be a green. Now a green's going to be here and. That them two are going to be red. That one's got 2 red connected to it, so that's 2 there. That one's got 2 red connected to it, so those 2 are already red, so those 2 be green. Those 2 be green. I misclicked. That's got nothing around it, so that's a red. That's got another red around it, so that's there. That's got another red next to it, so green. Wait, they're all green now. Green, 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 green. Magic. I picked up 1 gold. I win. As you can see, your health goes down as you get hit. The more you fail, the more you lose HP. I really like this. It's a really nice little rogue game. Now you come across a gambler. These are little random events. The whole thing's random. Completely randomly generated. The evil is coming right at you. Oh no. Another monster to attack. So that's a very fun little game that you can use with your mouse. It's got no keyboard support, from what I can see. Okay, so now I'm going to show you the last game that I'm going to be showing you, Survival Craft. Now, Survival Craft, it has partial keyboard and mouse support. Now, why I mean partial, it's not like, let's say, Fallout 3 or Brutal Doom, where you can use WASD to run around and use your mouse to look around. This has partially got that. So in the settings, you can set what your buttons do. Somewhere. I just can't remember. I don't think you do. But either way, let me just quickly jump into a world and show you how you can control this with a mouse and keyboard. I don't think there is rebindable keys. Okay, so... Oh, there you go, not WASD, my bad. Arrow keys to move around. Hold left click. And you're now playing the game pretty much like a PC game. Now, I believe this is creative. Oh yeah, this is creative. I'm destroying blocks far too quickly. Think of this as like a Minecraft clone done better than Minecraft. It really has been done better than Minecraft because it's got partial keyboard and mouse support. Minecraft doesn't have this, folks. So I can literally run around, I can go build whatever I like, and go punch a bird in the face if I can get close enough. I've already killed a couple of dogs. That was kind of fun. You can fly around. Whee! Woo! Crouch. Walk around. Now the one thing I noticed doesn't work is when you're crouching, you can't move around. However, if I press WASD here, which, for some reason, WASD doesn't quite work. Something's not quite right there. Maybe it's the way my tablet's set up, so maybe I've just broken it. Which is possible. So, as you can see, this pretty much works pretty well, if I say so myself. You can choose what you want to use on your hotbar. You've got your option keys here. You can do pretty much essentially whatever you want to do if you're playing Minecraft. So Survival Craft, while it does require money, I think it's got a demo, so you can definitely try it out. So that game works with keyboard and mouse. That's pretty much the main game that has keyboard and mouse support. Now, I did say that was the last game. I meant that was the last Android game. Now, here we're going to go on to a subject that some people are a little touchy about. The rest are just like, hell yeah, that's essentially what Android's made for. Emulators. Now, I've got an emulator for a lot of things. I've got a SNES emulator, a Game Boy Color, Game Boy emulator, a Game Boy Advance emulator, a DS emulator, a Nintendo 64 emulator, a Game Gear, a Genesis Mega Drive emulator, a PlayStation 1 emulator, and an NES emulator. I keep meaning to get Atari emulators, I just haven't got around to it yet. Now, you can play these games with keyboards. You can rebind them completely fine with keyboards. However, I mentioned this very early on in the video. Android supports PlayStation 3 controllers. So if you've got a PlayStation 3 controller, you can play all these games with the controller, which is infinitely more fun and more satisfying than ever playing with a keyboard. Think about that for a second. Could this be as fun as playing on the PC? Of course it can be as fun, but never more fun, because the PC can do everything and play every game under the sun. Android can only play what it's capable of, and no PC games. But all these emulated games, this is really darn fun. You could literally just plug in your controller and play yourself some Tekken. You could play yourself some Jacob Coon, Final Fantasy. You could play yourself some Streets of Rage, Sonic the Hedgehog, Super Mario Bros. You could play anything you wanted, even Pokemon Yellow, if you fancied it. The list is endless so long as your device supports playing with these emulators. Pretty much every emulator on Android supports rebindable keys with the keyboard or a controller. So I'm going to opt to be using this. Okay, so as you can see, I now have this wired and plugged into the tablet. Now, if you had a USB hub, you could just plug all of these in and never have to touch the wires ever again. Unfortunately, as I said earlier, this thing doesn't support a USB hub, unfortunately, so I had to swap the USB port. So now I've plugged this into a USB, micro USB OTG cable, on the go cable. So there we go. Now I can plug in my PS3 controller. Now, apparently you can get it to connect with Bluetooth, but some people have problems with that and others require root. I find it so much easier just to plug it in. It just works. So I'm just going to quickly go on a few games via the Game Boy. So I'm just going to go on a few games via this. So let's play some... Tekken 3! Why the heck not?
Okay, so as you can see, we are in Tekken 3 right now on the tablet. As you can see, the user interface is at the bottom. Now, one of the problems with this, if you have gone the route I've taken and plugged it in and unplugged the keyboard and mouse, you can no longer leave the games via keyboard. You pretty much have to use the touchscreen on your device, so that's kind of a problem. So, as you can see, we're now in arcade mode. I'm just going to play as Horong. For some reason, with this PS3 controller, I am on the right, and I don't know why, but I just am. Ooh, it's a bit laggy. Why are you a bit laggy? This game usually runs quite well on here. Come on, Nina. I can take you on. Boop. I'm gonna perfect you, bit. Aw, oh, damn it. Ah, well. Woo! Really love this game. This was like the first ever game I played on the PS1. But this is an absolute fantastic game. Come at me. So anyway, that's that. I'm gonna quickly leave that. Okay, so now we're in the Game Boy Advanced emulator. As you can see, I'm not gonna go. This is gonna be the last game I'm gonna go through because I gotta have some Pac-Man. Pac-Man's like the best game that was ever released ever. So naturally, I'm gonna play some Game Boy games. Now, Game Boy games are pretty easy to emulate. A and B, up, down, left, right. Pretty simple. Start, select. You can emulate most consoles. The hardest one to emulate is Genesis because it requires 6 buttons, so you have to rebind 2 of these to go for the other buttons that aren't quite on there, which is pretty much a pain in the backside. So let's continue. How do I start a new game? There we go. I absolutely love Pac-Man. And as you can see, it runs perfectly fine. Don't even need those 2 buttons. It's pretty much play like this. I don't even know why I ate that, but I don't know why. Whoop! He's chasing me. And I'm gonna eat you. No, I'm not. Because I derped. Oh, there we go. He ran into my mouth. Good enough. I forget how easy it is when you first start out. I was gonna get that cherry. That's not fair. So yeah, that is the Android desktop environment. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I hope you learned something. I hope you tried this project out yourself. It's pretty fun. It's pretty expensive to do if you've already got half of the things you require, such as a HDMI, mini HDMI cable. If you have a lot of devices, you should have a mini HDMI cable. If not, they are pretty inexpensive. They're pretty cheap on eBay, a few quid, nothing much. This will probably be the most expensive thing to buy, because I don't think unofficial controllers work on Android. I don't own one. I've got 4 PS3 controllers, so I'm pretty good in that regard when it comes to PS3 controllers. Now, as for everything else you may require, it's relatively cheap on eBay. If you've only got a DVI monitor, like I said, just get a little connector. It's a few quid on eBay, if that. I think mine was 99p. It was very cheap. Looks very similar to this, except instead of VGA, that'll be HDMI. And there's DVI. So it's pretty much set up and pretty much good to go. If anybody has got any insight on a cheaper way to split the HDMI audio, I'd really appreciate knowing that, because it really sucks having to basically have all the audio go to my TV. Because what if I was using it on a monitor that doesn't quite have audio? You'll have a very silent computer. But then again, it depends how you're using it. If you're using it just for office work, it's really an expensive office computer, but then again, you can buy really cheap Windows XP machines, can't you, for maybe 50 quid? Even cheaper than that. The towers are really cheap these days. I've got billions. I could give them all away. But I hope you guys learned something, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care.